They say, oh, let's see, he's angry at NATO. I guess, yeah, he loves Russia. I love Russia. I will say this, I'm meeting with President Putin next week and getting along, let me tell you, getting along with Russia and getting along with China and getting along with other countries is a good thing. It's not a bad thing, it's a good thing. Now they're saying it with Putin. Well, Putin is highly prepared. And Trump, will he be prepared for the meeting? Yeah. Trust me, we'll do just fine. We'll do just fine. Fake news, bad people. Will he be prepared? Will he be prepared? And I might even end up having a good relationship, but they're going, will President Trump be prepared? You know, President Putin is KGB and this and that. You know what? Putin's fine. He's fine. We're all fine. We're people. Will I be prepared? Totally prepared. I've been preparing for this stuff my whole life. They don't say that. They don't say that. They make it impossible to do business in Europe, yet they come in and they sell their Mercedes and their BMWs to us. So we have $151 billion in trade deficits with the EU. Every day we are keeping our promises. We've created 3.4 million jobs since Election Day, which nobody can even believe. Nobody can believe it. Nobody believes it. I always say, if I would have said that on the campaign trail, when I was here or anyplace else, it would have been brutal. They would have said, how can you possibly say a thing like that? 3.4 million new jobs, unemployment claims are at a 45-year low. African American and Hispanic American unemployment have reached the lowest levels in the history of our country. Remember, what do you have to lose? Remember, what do you have to lose? People didn't like it when I said that. What do you have to lose? Guess what? We're right. In fact, a new poll came out last week. We're up in like a week, 10 points with the Hispanic community, 10 points. Because they want to be safe. Unemployment among women is at the lowest level it's been in 65 years and within a couple of weeks history. Our economic policy can be summed up in three very simple but beautiful words. Jobs, jobs, jobs. Since the election, we have lifted 3 million people off of food stamps. And by the way, on a humanitarian basis, that's a great thing. Do you know how much money we save by doing that as a country? 3 million people, and it's going up fast. Wages for the first time in 18 years are rising again. People can go out, they can actually choose a job, and they have wages that are rising. And 6 months ago, Republicans passed the biggest tax cuts in American history. The biggest in American history. Everybody in this room is benefiting. Everybody is benefiting. The United States of America was the piggy bank that everybody was robbing. And let me tell you, our allies in many cases were worse than our enemies. We opened our country to their goods, but they put up massive barriers to keep our products and our goods the hell out of their country because they didn't want that competition. And that's not free trade, that's stupid trade. We're not gonna do that. We don't do that anymore. We have to have fair and reciprocal, that being the more important word. We need reciprocal. They charge a 50% tax. We charge a 50% tax. Then we say, look, let's bring it to nothing, or I don't care, one way or the other, do whatever you want. And then I'll have people complaining. They'll say, it's incredible. So we have countries ripping us off for years. And then when I say, well, look, we're going to put tariffs on there because they have been ripping us. We have trade deficits. They have surpluses. That would be unbelievable. So they have all of this. And I say, we are going to do something about it. And I'll get calls from some politicians. Oh, that's terrible. I said, no, you don't understand. We're going to make great deals. No, no, that's just leave it the way it is. Please, just leave it the way it is. Leave it the way it is. I said, no, no. We have all the cards. We're the bank that everybody's stealing from. I respect China and I respect President Xi, but they've been killing us. $507 billion in trade deficits last year. 507. Who the hell can lose 500? Then you want to do something about it, you get attacked. Oh, that's not nice. That's not free trade. The war was lost on trade many years ago. You know, when they were saying, not a free trader, I said, no, no, the war was lost. But now we're going to win it. And because we have all the cards. Do you know that if we knock down the trade deficit, right, the trade deficit, by just a little bit, 25%, and we can do that easily. That's easy. If we do that, we pick up 1 point in GDP. Does anybody know that? That's $3 trillion, and that's 10 million jobs. That's just 25%. We pick up 1 point. And speaking of GDP, remember when I'd say it's going to go to 3% pretty quickly and all of this? Well, now the Atlanta Fed just predicted 4.8%. Now, who knows? Who knows? Who knows? Who knows?